1995. Environmentalist and author Ken Sara-Wiwa is hanged along with eight others by the Nigerian government. Sara-Wiwa is a campaigner on behalf of the Ogoni people to achieve autonomy and to protect their lands and natural resources from exploitation by Shell. The conviction by a kangaroo court causes outrage and brings worldwide attention to the issue of oil and gas exploration in ecologically sensitive regions, and to the influence of multinational corporations over their governments. 10 years later, in a remote area on the Atlantic seaboard in Mayo, Ireland, another miscarriage of justice is about to happen. 5 men are jailed for attempting to prevent Shell from building a gas pipeline across their lands. These men will become known as the Rossport Five.
October 2004. Shell Oil is granted planning permission by An Bord Pleanála, the Irish planning body, to build an onshore gas refinery, the first such refinery in the world. April 2005. The Irish government grants Shell compulsory purchase orders for the construction of a gas pipeline from the Corrib field, 70 kilometres off the Mayo coast, to the onshore refinery. The planned pipeline will hit landfall in the townland of Rossport. Shell also gains compulsory access orders enabling workers to enter private lands at their discretion.
June 2005. 5 residents from Rossport are jailed for refusing to undertake not to interfere with the construction of the pipeline on their lands. These citizens represent a core of concerned residents in Rossport. Their main objection is the raw, unprocessed nature of the gas which the planned pipeline will carry at high pressure over their lands and near their homes. The high pressure of the gas and the proximity of the pipeline to inhabited areas means that any accident could be catastrophic. 30th of September 2005. Public pressure and countrywide protests lead to the release of the Rossport Five after 94 days in Clover Hill Prison. However, the matter remains unresolved as Shell still plans to go ahead with the construction of the dangerous pipeline, and the residents of Rossport refuse to back down. Tuesday, 3rd of October 2006, the operation begins in earnest. After previous attempts are prevented by local protesters, Shell workers gain access to the terminal site. They are forced through by 200 Gardaí who physically remove locals from the gate. At least 2 people are injured by Gardaí and a media campaign attempts to blacken the protesters. The site is now under police occupation. By going to prison, the Rossport Five sought to guarantee the safety of their community by getting the gas processed at sea. However, there are deeper concerns.
Firstly, the wholesale giveaway of the entire Corrib gas field to Shell with no benefit to the state whatsoever. The state has paid all Shell's expenses in exploring Irish waters backdated 25 years. The operation will be based in Irish Scotland with no obligation to avail of Irish labour or services. The state receives no royalties for gas extracted from Irish waters and buys the gas back from Shell at the going market rate. Shell makes no contribution toward providing the infrastructure required to bring the gas into the Irish network. Thus, the Irish taxpayer funds the entire operation and gains nothing. Second, the gift of executive powers to Shell to enforce compulsory purchase orders and compulsory access orders. In essence, Shell has been given state power and the right to use it at will against Irish citizens. Shell can act as it wishes without any responsibility to the welfare of the country or its people. This constitutes the erosion of the democratic rights and hard-won liberties guaranteed by the Irish Constitution. Remember, this is the same government that granted the Minister for the Environment the power to destroy national monuments.
The Corrib and related gas fields have been estimated to contain 6 to 11 trillion cubic feet of natural gas. A conservative guess puts its projected value at 50.4 billion euro. What are the lives of a few Irish people compared to that? The Irish government has bowed to a company directly implicated in the deaths of 9 Nigerians, as well as atrocities against the Ogoni and the theft of their natural resources. A company which demands that indigenous people roll over while the world either wrings its hands or looks the other way. The people of Rossport are fighting back, standing alone against a multi-billion dollar corporation. They have held fast for centuries, fighting against foreign occupation, ruthless landlords, and crushing poverty. Rossport is no longer just the name of a small Irish community. It is the symbol of a global struggle to protect the rights and the resources of sovereign peoples. It is the fight to defend democracy against the collaboration between elected governments and unaccountable corporations. It is the conviction that resources belong to the people and are not to be given away to profit the few while the millions suffer.
Have lived.